we're looking at here is what we call an uncorrected IR image. You can see some of the variation between the pixels and areas that stick out from the surrounding. As I step back, we'll add the correction in, and you'll see the smooth quality IR image you're used to seeing from Sierra-Olympia products. Let's head into the studio and we'll talk about how the non-uniformity correction process works and how we do it here at Sierra-Olympia. Because infrared sensors are made from exotic materials using advanced processing techniques, each detector, each individual detector in the sensor, has its own characteristic in the way it responds to incoming infrared light. Each detector, you might say, has its own personality compared with those around it. How we create a good-looking IR image out of that is a non-uniformity correction, or what we call a nuke. What's a nuke, a non-uniformity correction? That answer has two parts. The first part happens at our factory in the test process on our cameras. We use this area black body, which is a device that's able to show a uniform scene to the sensor, and we can vary that temperature to give it different intensities. So what we do is, you can imagine showing a lower intensity image and a higher intensity image to a certain pixel, let's say. And we can plot the intensities on the x-axis and the response of the pixel on the y-axis, and we can find the characteristic of that one pixel and plot it. Now, if we do that on another pixel, let's say the adjacent pixel to that one, we're going to find that that pixel will have a slightly different characteristic. The reason this happens is because, even if it's the same material on the same substrate, the way that we make detectors happens at a micro scale. We use an automated computer program to go through each of the 300,000 pixels in the array and alter each one individually so that the entire array becomes. Now, for the second phase of non-uniformity correction, we need to load all of those calculated coefficients into the camera so that it can do the corrections while it's imaging. Now, we sort of take that for granted, because once we load those coefficients into the camera, it just starts working and creates a beautiful image for us. But I try to remember that we're creating 30 frames per second of image data. Each of those frames has 300,000 pixels in it, and every single one of those pixels needs to receive its particular correction in order to bring it in line with the rest. So there are millions of pixels per second getting corrected in order to create the uniform image out of this camera. Here at Sierra-Olympia, we are experimenting with other ways of doing non-uniformity correction. You can imagine that some pixels maybe don't respond in a straight line across all intensities. Maybe they have a curved characteristic to them. And if different pixels on the array have slightly different curves, that's another way that non-uniformity can come into an image. So we've been experimenting with using a three-point correction, where not only do we just move the two points around, but we can also change the shape of that curve and make differently shaped curves match up with each other so that the image remains uniform across the entire range of intensities. Another way that non-uniformity can be introduced into an IR image is through the optical system. In those types of cases, Sierra has developed a nuke through zoom capability, where we can actually calculate multiple nuke tables, multiple nuke sets, and switch them as a lens goes through its different positions in order to make the best possible image at each zoom position. Thanks for watching this Tech Talk. I hope this has helped to describe how we take groups of hundreds of thousands of pixels in a detector array and bring all of their characteristics together to form a nice uniform image.